What is up, everyone, and welcome back to
Simon the Fan.
Excited to have you guys here with us. These kids are always in our room. Last night we were watching a movie. I brought them back into their rooms, and somehow they still managed to get back in here. I think they're in love with my mattress. Today's video is sponsored by Beautyrest.
Ew!
What's going on, eh, buddy?
I said beauty.
I said Beautyrest.
You say booty.
I didn't say booty, I said beauty rest, okay? Anyhow, today's video is sponsored by Beauty Rest. For last year, we gave you guys updates, monthly updates, on how the mattress was treating us. Now it's been a year, so I thought I'd give you guys a quick update again. Final update after 1 year of how the Beauty Rest mattress has been for us.
Kids and guess what, guys? I'm starting school next weekend.
Oh, yes. Not next weekend, but next week.
Yeah, next week and next week.
The Beautyrest mattress has been our safe haven in this household. Who has the most comfortable bed in the house?
You. Definitely.
Not that. Me.
You? No, I don't think so, buddy. The Beautyrest mattress, hybrid mattress specifically, has been gold. One of my main goals with Beautyrest mattress was to get uninterrupted sleep. And I can truly say that when I knock out, we out of here. We in La La Land. We are dreaming about the best things in life, okay?
And La La Land.
That's what the hybrid mattress by Beautyrest has been doing for me, so I've reached my goal.
Booty.
I strongly recommend Beautyrest. I mean, just the name, they've been here, well, you know, 100 years plus. They know everything about mattresses, okay? A couple of my favorite features of my hybrid mattress is it's compatible with an adjustable base. The next feature that I love is the right temp feature, which pulls heat away from your body, keeping you cool all night. I rarely have to touch thermostat while I'm sleeping. In fact, I usually gotta turn off the AC. I guess the right temp feature contributes in keeping me cool. Deals, y'all want deals? Check this out. So right now, get $400 off of Beautyrest black mattresses and $200 off of the Hybrid X Class mattress, which is the one I have. All the links in the description. So last night, while watching the movie, I actually knocked out. I woke up this morning and I seen so much goldfish, and I think I need to teach these kids some eating etiquette, dining etiquette, and that's exactly what's gonna happen today. No more eating in rooms, okay? I'm gonna teach you guys how to eat nicely.
How?
Show me.
Dad, sissy.
Yeah?
Okay, let's go. I play no games, let's go.
You don't play no games?
No.
She's always trying to play games. Let's do this. Okay, also, dining etiquette. I thought it was very important that we make a video about this because even us adults, I feel like a lot of us missed out on this portion of mannerism. So we gonna get schooled by Crystal. She gonna guide us on how to eat like proper Samaritans, proper civilians, Samaritans. Yeah, anyhow, let's do it. Okay guys, so Samir and Zane is here, Crystal's here, she has set up all the plates, we're gonna be doing some dining etiquette, and we're gonna learn how to eat the right way, the good way, the correct way, with manners. Say etiquette.
Etiquette.
Awesome, okay.
All right, so.
Teach us.
This is the proper. This is the proper setting for informal. So this is like when you're eating with your family, if you're at someone's house, or if you're at a regular restaurant. If you're at someplace fancy, you'll have like 5 forks.
Ooh.
And 3 knives and like 6 spoons. So this is just what you do every day, okay? So the way you think about
look and listen.
Is you set everything this way, the way you want to eat. So normally we eat salad first, or you know, you get a bread course at the beginning when we go to a restaurant. So bread goes here. And then if you want to eat salad, you eat it with the small fork because salad is first. And then what'll happen is the waiter will take these away and then you go with either soup. Does anyone like soup?
That would be a soup or this would be a soup?
This is dessert. So this is always last. So this is for soup. And then this one is when you eat dinner. Mm-hmm. So you have soup next, and then you're left with dinner. And this is what you get at dinner, right? You need a fork, you need a knife if you cut anything up, and then this is the plate where your food is gonna go. And then this is your napkin. So what do you do with your napkin when you're at a restaurant?
You wipe. Wipe.
You wipe your mouth, yes. But when you first start at a restaurant, when you sit down, you're gonna put your napkin on your lap. And that's because if we're a messy eater, you don't get food on your clothes.
I'm not a messy eater, I don't need this.
Well, it's not that you need it, it's that's what you're supposed to do. Everyone does it at a restaurant.
Exactly. How about those who put it on like the hand?
No, so you never put it here unless you're at like a crab spot or where it's like really messy with your hands. Mm-hmm. But when you're at a proper spot, you just put it in your lap like this.
And I noticed you had it on the left side.
Yes.
It always goes on the left side?
It always goes on the left side. So if there's no charger plate, it goes to the left of the forks. It doesn't go underneath the forks. If there's a charger plate, it goes in the middle of the charger plate, and then you remove it and put it on your lap before the waiter, well, the waiter will always serve you from the right. So before the waiter puts your food on the plate. So Zane, put your napkin in your lap, like your sister. So do you remember what this is for?
Uh-huh.
What?
Bread,
that's right.
Good job, Zane.
And then what do we use this for?
Soup.
This one is soup. No. Soup is for a spoon. What's this one? Salad.
Salad.
Right. And then what's this one?
For fork.
No.
Dinner.
Dinner.
Right. And then whenever you have this knife, the knife always has to be inside. It's for cutting, so you don't cut yourself. So don't put it this way, because you might cut yourself when you're grabbing your spoon. You always make sure it faces inside the plate.
I did not know that. That was good.
You've got to be careful with knives.
Yes,
absolutely.
You got to be very careful. So you make sure it faces in so you don't accidentally touch the blade. And then for your drinks, you guys are too young for wine, but your glasses always go on the right. So for you guys, you're too young, so you just have a water glass. But normally for adults, they put their adult beverage glass here too. And then if you don't want an adult beverage, the waiter will take it away. Okay?
Okay. Hey, you gotta sit upright. You can't slouch. No slouching. Yeah. You can't do that, actually.
Don't do that. I want the chicken.
That's okay, you don't have to eat the chicken. I'm just gonna show you what you need to do. So, what did we say we eat first?
Dinner!
No, we eat the bread first, because we start from this side. So the bread is here. So if you don't want the bread, then you can just leave it and you can start with your dinner. We don't have salad today, which means we don't need these, and which means we don't need these.
What about that?
Good question.
So that's a good question. So this is for dessert. So Ooh. Sometimes when you want ice cream or if you want cake.
We don't have ice cream. Do we?
So go ahead and eat, and I'll tell you what your bad habits are. You don't need this yet, Zany. Just your fork and knife.
Good job,
Oh, so see, Samia is already doing something bad. Okay. You're not supposed to put your elbows on the table, ever. Yeah. It's very rude.
How should she hold the fork?
So you should always hold the fork.
Why can you not be your elbows
Zane
on the table?
Zane is holding it backwards.
So always hold your fork like this.
Yeah, but Zane, this is a really good question. Why do you not allow to put your elbows on there?
Because it's just considered rude. It's kind of like you're just relaxing like this. And Zane is holding his fork and knife properly, and he's sitting up straight. So this is how you're supposed to eat.
Should his food plate be a little closer to him?
Yes, so for him, his plate should be a bit closer.
Our food is healthy, so it can be strong.
Yes, food is healthy, so it makes you nice and strong. And so another thing that we don't do at the table is we don't burp and we don't slurp our food. So you know, sometimes when you have soup and it does that, that's bad. You just gotta have nice conversation. So for example, you could ask Zane, how was daycare today?
Zane, so how was your day today?
Good.
How was the water park?
Good. It's not
you
good.
You played with your friends today?
Yeah.
And then, so that's another good thing that Zane just did. When you wanna interrupt someone at the table, you say, excuse me, and you wait for them to respond. And if you want, say you wanna eat Zane's bread, how do you ask him?
Please.
Please, right. So at the table, you have to remember to say please.
But someone comes in the door, you gotta open it.
Right, you gotta be polite and have manners. Because you wanna be polite so people invite you back to eat, right?
Yes.
So no elbows,
No apples on the table like that.
Right. What else did you learn?
Like this. If you don't want to eat the bread right now, you can eat your dinner first.
Right. What about noises?
If you slip, you can't do that.
Right.
And if you fart, you can't do
that. You just say excuse me, or you can get up and go do it in private in the bathroom.
Fire fart like this. Oh, you gotta scream excuse me.
Yeah, exactly. If you if it happens,
but
you say excuse me.
Oh, what about feeding people?
You should never feed other people at the table. That's very rude.
He feed me.
That's different. You're his daughter, so that's okay. But if you're out with like your friends, you wouldn't feed your friends. Like if Adam and I were out eating, he's not gonna feed me.
I was gonna say, what are your thoughts about people who be eating on your plate and stuff?
Personally, I hate that. It's definitely rude. Mm-hmm. But so if you want something, Samia, that Zane has, or he wants something that you have, you should just use a spare plate and pass it to him.
No, Zane, nothing.
He shouldn't be eating off your plate. That's rude.
Comment below if you guys are finding this informative.
What about if someone serves you the food and you ask for food and they don't give you the right food?
Then you say, excuse me.
Excuse me.
And then you tell them what's wrong with your food. So
in a very respectful way.
Yeah.
Okay, you never be rude to anyone. Even if you've been waiting for so long and you're hungry, you don't be mad. You can be mad, but you don't do that.
Yeah.
So like,
when we sat down earlier, Zane said he didn't want his chicken. So what he should have said is, I'm sorry, I don't eat this. Can you take it back, please?
Yes, that's how you talk.
I don't eat this. I can take it back, please.
Okay, so I'll take the chicken off your plate. There you go. See, so that's what the waiter would do. I mean, they would serve you from the right, but yes, they would have removed it from your plate and brought you back something fresh. We also don't eat with our hands.
Hey.
We always use a fork.
Okay, grab it.
So now you have to dap your hands on your napkin.
How do you know all about this?
My parents made me take a class. So I learned how to eat properly at the table. Because like you, I ate like a savage.
We don't want to be savages. We just want to eat with respect and proper manners.
I can't eat but this.
No laughing when eating too. I'm just joking. You can laugh. You don't want to choke. You have to be careful.
I'm not going to eat nothing. Okay, can I maybe excuse please? Here you go.
Thank you. What about you, Zane? Are you done or are you still eating?
I'm still eating.
Okay, so wait, we just learned something new. Put everything down. So when you're at the table with other people, you don't ask them to remove your plate when other people are eating. You just say, you put your fork and knife together and you say, can I be excused please?
Hey, I think if you're done, you're done.
Yes, you may.
Can I please make me excuse, please?
Yes, you may.
Okay.
And now they're enjoying some dessert. Okay, y'all. Hope you learned a few things about dining etiquette. Very informative. Good job.
Thanks.
Good. Comment below. Let me know if you guys learned a couple of things. Samia and Zane, did you learn how to eat nicely?
Yes.
Respectfully?
Yes.
Okay, so moving forward, can't be savages, right?
No, you're savage.
I'm not a savage. I'm
always, always, all the time, you be talking, let me eat your food, you be going on your phone, you're not supposed to be going on your phone.
I can admit to that.
And that means you're savage. You're savage and you're bougie.
I'm a savage.
We're all gonna work on it, right? We're gonna work on our dining etiquette. Daddy won't be on his phone as much.
That's true. I got to do better.
I'm on my phone. Zane won't have food all over the floor because he'll have a napkin on his lap. Samia won't use her elbows on the table. We'll practice that, right?
Mm-hmm. Shout out to today's sponsor, Beautyrest. All links in the description below. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe to
Simon Fam.
Thank you, Crystal, again.
Bye.
We out.